Praise the Lord. Praise the living God. I want to take a song, then we go. Jesus, you are worthy. Savior, thou art worthy. Thou alone art worthy to be praised. Thank God for the privilege to share this little with us this morning. We are talking, this issue came up as a result of some certain accidental deaths. Deaths as a result of ignorance, certain deaths that could be avoided. There are some health issues that are not curable, but they can be managed, and the person will still fulfill the number of his or her days. And one of these health issues is hypertension. Hypertension is high raise in blood, high in blood pressure. When the blood is pumped, the arterial blood pressure is increased. And it is a silent killer. It's one of the first leading cause of death in the whole world. And we discover that ignorance has brought it right in the church. The Bible says that out of ignorance, that lack of knowledge has made the children of God to be ignorant. So we want to know little and how to control and how to avoid it and prevent such illnesses. As we all know, what are the causes of this illness? Most of the causes are stress. The things that cause stress could be loss of loved one, loss of job. Like we all know, last year, we were in the era of change, era of recession. That can cause many head of families to have hypertension. And because this illness goes unnoticed, so it kills silently. The person discovers that he just slumps. The person discovers he has some headache, nervousness, dizziness. And before you know it, somebody you just saw yesterday, you'll be told he slumped and died. And how does this happen? When the brain, it becomes a kind of cardiovascular accident. The brain is crushed and there is bleeding in the brain and it has no cure. The person dies immediately. How do we know we have hypertension? By checking your blood pressure regularly. And after checking your blood pressure, I will give you some list of certain range for certain ages. So when your blood pressure exceeds that range, you know there is need for you to seek help and take care of yourself. Because God is interested in us taking care of our body. Praise the living God. Praise the living God. There are some of us seated here today, they have raised blood pressure. But some faint it. They say it cannot happen. And as a result, they don't take drugs. Blood pressure can be managed for years. As much, I know a man that has blood pressure for 55 years and is still alive because he was able to take his drugs and keep to his clinic appointments. So we are trying to encourage that there is need for regular check of blood pressure so that we live a healthy life and fulfill the theme for this year that God is going to perform in our lives. Praise the living God. Some of the other signs the person notices when it is high and you have never known it's hypertensive is that there is facial paralysis. There is numbness. The person will be wondering, why is it so? There is need to check blood pressure. You know, blood pressure, hypertension can as well, it can be essential. In that case, it's not, the person did not do anything, it just came up. Hypertension could be urgent. They call it urgency. Hypertension could be as a result of something triggering it. It also runs in family. So especially for those that know it runs in their family, should take special care of themselves. Some of them, their parents had hypertension. So for such individual, there is need for regular check and regular visits of clinics. Praise the living God. Some have hypertension also in pregnancy, and they are not hypertensive even before pregnancy. And some with this hypertension, it also prevents them from getting pregnant. So I'm going to start from 1 year to 12 months. That is 1 month to 12 months. You'll be wondering, can such a baby have hypertension? Yes, it happens. So for the range is 75 over 50 to 110/75. So when a 1 year old child's blood pressure is higher than 101/75, there is need for drug treatment to bring it to normal level and for checkups. From 1 year to 5 years of age, the minimum is 80/55. And the normal of that age is 95/65. Then when it gets to 110/79, there is need for urgent medical care to avoid stroke, because babies also have stroke. Then 6 years to 13 years of age, the minimum of their blood pressure is 90/60, and the normal level for them is 105/70. Then the highest is 115/80. So when it is highest, the child will begin to show some of these signs and symptoms, and some may go unnoticed. Then for 14 years to 19 years of age, the minimum is 105/73, and the normal of that age is 117/77. And the highest of such age is 120/81. Once it exceeds, that is hypertension. Then 20 years to 24 years of age, 108/75 is the minimum range, and 121/80 is the normal range for that age group. 132/83, it is the highest, and if it exceeds, please, there is need for regular checkup. That is even a sign for such child to be checking it regularly. For 25 years to 29 years of age, the minimum is 109/76, and the normal blood pressure for that age, according to World Health Organization, the current blood pressure chart is 122/81, and the normal for that age group is 133/84, and it is the highest level. So when it gets to this level, there is need for medical treatment. Then from 30 to 34 years of age, 110/77, then the normal range is 122/81. Then once you get to 134/85, there is urgent need for emergency. Then 35 to 39, 111/78. The normal range for that group is 123/82. And the highest of that age to seek for help is 137/87. Then 40 to 44 years, the normal range for that age is 125/83. Once it gets to 137/87, there is need for, that is hypertension, and it can move higher and result to stroke. Then 45 to 49, the normal range is 127/84. Once it gets to 139/80, there is need for urgent help. 50 to 54 years, the normal range is 129/85. Once it gets to 142/89, there is need for urgent help. And when it's below 116/81, that is hypotension, it is as well dangerous. Then 55 to 59 years, the normal range is 131/86. Once you get to 144/90, there is need for medical care. Then 60 to 64 years, the normal range for that age is 134/87. Once you get to 147/91, there is need for help. Previously, the range of high blood pressure for the normal range of blood pressure is 140, 100 over 60 to 140 over 100. But this has changed to this because of what we are experiencing. So, brethren, the purpose of this is there is need to check your blood pressure. And when it is discovered that it's high, and you are advised to seek hospital attention, to go and see a cardiologist. Hypertension could also be renal. You may need to see a renal doctor that will investigate to know actually what is going on. Please do not hesitate to go. Do not assume God heals all these things, because from the beginning it was not so. But at the same time, to avoid hypertension completely is to, that is the power of praise to manage stress. Being grateful, having a heart of gratitude, being thankful to God at all times, being contented, living a life as you see it, and believing God, and holding on to the belief you have, that can prevent you from hypertension. And if it is there already, there is need for control. You maintain, there is a kind of drug maintenance. Please do not patronize quacks, and do not use self-medication. These are dangerous. And when it occurs, it comes silently. It affects, why we are angry is that it affects men, the breadwinner of homes, because of their struggle. They are struggling for food, school fees. They tend to have stress. And even when they notice that they are having headache, they go to take paracetamol. So this brings about drug abuse. Like we said earlier, one of the causes of this hypertension also is lifestyle and obesity. So we need to watch our weight, what the kind of food we eat. We may say we are Christians. Some of us smoke indirectly. Some of us are third-party smokers. So we avoid such smokes because this affects the heart. And it's from hypertension, it goes to other cardiovascular diseases. Again, there are other diseases in the body that can be a cause of hypertension. Not necessarily that the person is hypertensive, but when the system in the body has broken down, there is autoimmune problems, it can bring about hypertension. Please, brethren, as we are already in a new year, a year of a great year, a year that we will no more see this, that the Lord Jesus Christ will neutralize it from our body in Jesus' name. Thank you so much.
Wait, for men who call
prostate. There is need for men, because at a particular stage, the men should do prostate check, and there is an instant check of prostate. They check, prostate cancer is also another killer disease, and that occurs to men. It's men that has prostate gland. For the women, it's cervical cancer, and to crown it all, the beautiful thing about cervical cancer is that it is curable if it is detected early. And so far, in the Women Fellowship, they have been able to do it on a yearly basis, checking so that if there is an impediment, it will be taken care of before it becomes the proper one that cannot be curable. But cervical cancer is curable, and cervical cancer has vaccine. They have vaccine that every girl child from before the child is sexually active is to take the vaccine. It's in 3 doses. And if it's taken, it covers the child for life. Men also need to do screening. Men, because of the kind of nature of your constitutional makeups, there is need for every man to have the prostate check. So if it is checked early and there is a kind of a sign, then early treatment can prevent further destructions. Praise God.
Can we clap our hands now? Thank you very much. Do we release her to go? You have any question, important question? Is she confused you anywhere? Can we release her to go? Question quickly. Quickly. Stand up quickly. Microphone, please. Stand wherever you are. Just ask your question, please.
Praise
yes,
God.
Please.
Please, in your teaching, you mentioned the word renal, and that renal, there could be renal cause of hypertension. I don't know what renal means.
Praise the Lord. Renal is the kidneys. When there is hypertension that is caused as a result of renal influences, that is the kidney having a problem, it can bring hypertension, such as kidney stones, kidney cancer can bring about hypertension. So when such occur, it is the doctor, the specialist in that area that handle that type of hypertension. So renal is the kidneys, and we have two kidneys, and it could be infected.
God bless you. Yes?
Please, madam. I want to know the causes of prostate cancer, and how can one easily check this thing to know if one is a victim of such, please.
Praise the Lord. Like we all know, cancer has no cause. The causes are unknown, but there are predisposing factors to prostate cancer. It is lifestyle. For a man that has, during his youthful age, has humanized so much, the prostate is in use at that stage of humanizing. So it affects the man later on as he gets older. Though some can be hereditary, that man did not do that and it comes. But most times, it happened to men that really had a kind of, in quote, enjoyment when they were younger.
Thank you. And
test is available. The test can even be, they can do the test maybe when they organize it, they can come here and do the test for all the men to detect who has it, and the person will be treated.
All right, thank you so much.
God bless you. Next person.
Shalom. You said something about immunization, vaccination for cervical cancer for children. How is it done?
Yes, cervical cancer has vaccine, and it is available in almost all the teaching hospitals. Working, but it's just that you pay for the services. It is not free. The government has not made it free. It is given in 3 doses. You give to your girl child. I think from 9 years and above, before the child is sexually exposed, the immunization is given. And if the child is sexually exposed, they do the screening. If proven negative, the immunization will be commenced.
Thank you.
Any other person?
Thank you, ma, for educating us. Please, I want to ask, somebody that is already having a high blood pressure, are there foods that the person can avoid?
Praise the Lord. Obviously, there are foods. The person will be on low salt diets. Salt tends to increase the blood pressure. The person will manage, be also not to be eating too much fried food. The person should watch his weight because obesity compounds it. You watch your weight, your lifestyle, you avoid alcohol, you avoid tobacco. These are things you will avoid. And secondly, go and visit a cardiologist. Go and visit a physician. Do not visit a doctor that is not a physician, because they are specialists in that case. So they know when to increase your drug, when to reduce, when to change, when to tell you to leave. So that is the need and the importance of this lecture, for you to visit a physician, a cardiologist that is specialized on treatment of such case, not to visit general doctor, because though they may have an idea, just like I'm telling you, but there are people that are specialized in taking care of such cases. And if they handle the case, there will be no crisis. That is why you see some, they have hypertension and they are living their normal life without having crisis. It is because of poor treatment, poor handling of the case that bring a crisis, that brings stroke. And when stroke comes, you know, it causes deformity, it affects the family, it affects the church, it affects the society at large. So that is what we are trying to avoid.
Thank you, Ma. The second one, can we have the chart of the range of blood pressure?
Go to internet.
Okay. Yes, that is what I just read here.
Okay. Go to internet.
Okay, thank you.
If you want to know, you can meet us in the medical team. We will give to you.
On the screen, sister, what is the cause of low blood pressure? How can it be managed for one that has been affected already?
low blood pressure, the cause is as well as whatever that causes it to go high can as well crash it. There are people, when they have some infections, it affects their blood pressure and it reduces it. There are people, when their blood pressure is so high and they take drugs, overdosage of drug or the inappropriate drug, it reduces it to low. There are people, when there are other autoimmune systems, it brings down the blood pressure to that low. Malaria can bring about low blood pressure as well as bringing about high blood pressure. Some other illnesses, that common illnesses around us, can bring it low. So, but when it is low, there is treatment for it, and the treatment is also, like we are directing you, to seek medical attention early when you notice such. And if you are always, there are people naturally, they have low blood pressure, and it is normal with their constitutional makeup. It does not affect their life, their daily activities. Their blood pressure is always low. Though, such, when they meet the specialist, they are advised on certain things to take. When it happens, there are certain things they tell them to take, and they take it regularly, and it is resolved. As we said, that this platform is not to prescribe drugs, or to just to direct you on the right thing to do, and to do it early enough to avoid crisis. Thank you.
The last person, please.
God bless you, ma.
God bless you.
Sorry, ma. I just want to know what causes that is epileptic. I want to know what is the cause of that and if there is cure for it or not. Because I've been experiencing these symptoms. So I just want to know what is the cause of it.
Praise the Lord. Epilepsy, there are so many causes of it. One, head injury, birth injury. When a child is born at birth and delay in crying, maybe the child has asphyxia, and is poorly treated, it brings about electrical discharges in the brain. It is a cause that can contribute, bringing about seizures, and the child grows with it. And as the seizure, from seizure, it graduates to epilepsy. Accidents can cause it. Trauma. I know a medical doctor, he was in medical school. While she was standing, you know, some girls stand this way. She just stand. Her colleague came behind and pushed her like this. She fell from three-story building and hit her head. That was the end of her schooling. She has epilepsy to date. That is one. Two, epilepsy is also seen as a psychiatric problem because it affects the brain cells. And there is abnormal electrical discharges. So whenever there are things that triggers it. Crowd triggers it. Noise triggers it. So the individual should detect what triggers the epilepsy and avoid such places. Yes, epilepsy can be controlled. Medically, so far, there is no man-made drug that they say it can clear it. Though you will see supplements, other people saying they can cure it in other areas, in alternative medicine. So, but in medical, you'll be treated and it will be controlled. You may never have an attack of epilepsy if you visit the doctors that treat epilepsy. The neurosurgeons, neurologists, they are the ones that treat epilepsy. So when you visit them, they place you on drugs. They can give you as far as 6 months clinic appointment. And if you follow your treatment and the things you are asked to avoid, it will be controlled and you may never have attack. And even when you want to have attack, you will have a kind of, you will notice it and you will leave the site to avoid disgrace. You are advised not to be in crowded places, parties, avoid alcohol, avoid so many things that are worldly and will expose you to having attacks. So, and each time, if you are a Christian, you are in the church, try and sit by the window side where you have enough air. Do not sit in the midst of crowd, especially when they are dancing and they are raising dust. Try and stay where you can have enough air, enough fresh air. That also will assist you. And please visit a psychiatrist, a neurologist. They are specialists and they will be able to attend to your care and you will be treated. treated and controlled. Thank you.
Church, can we clap your hands for Jesus? Oh, sorry, just before you close, the last one online. Sister Eddie Deongo from Uyo, on the issue of cervical cancer, please, is there no vaccine for a woman that is already bearing children?
Praise the Lord. Yes, there are vaccines. Women of childbearing age, they take the vaccine. The only difference is that it's not free like BCG and other immunizations. Visit a teaching hospital. Even some general hospitals, they give the vaccine. So you can take the vaccine, Sister Uyo. Praise the Lord.
Thank you very much, Sister Chika. God bless you.